In the last video, we talked about the continuity of functions like e to the x and log of x and sine of x and rational functions that were defined by a single formula. Now we're going to talk about functions that are defined in pieces. For example, we're going to look at this function f of x, which has one definition for x less than 2 and another definition for x bigger or equal to 2. And we're going to look at another function where the cutoff is at 3. And we're going to look at a third function that has a special definition at x equals 5 and a different definition for all values of x other than 5. And you may recognize this as the rational function that we looked at in the last video. Okay, so for each of these functions, we want to know where the function is continuous. And a strategy is we check it in each interval of definition. You know, for x less than 2, you use this definition. For x bigger than 2, you use this definition. But you have to be careful about what happens at x equals 2. You check the boundaries separately. At the boundaries, you've got one definition telling you what's happening when x is slightly less than a, and you have a different formula that tells you what's happening when x is slightly bigger than a, and maybe you have a third formula telling you what's happening when x is equal to a. You have to compute the limit from the left, the limit from the right, and the value separately, and you have to check that all three agree. So let's look at our first example. X minus 1 for x less than 2, 3 minus x for x bigger or equal to 2. Well, when it's less than 2, it's x minus 1, that's a polynomial. Polynomials are continuous, no problem. When x is bigger than 2, it's 3 minus x, that's a polynomial, it's continuous. What's left is to figure out what's happening at x equals 2. So to get the limit from the left, the limit from the left is figuring out what's happening for numbers that are slightly less than 2. And for numbers slightly less than 2, this is the formula that applies. We apply x minus 1. The limit of x minus 1 is 2 minus 1, that's 1. When x is slightly bigger than 2, we have to apply this formula. So the limit from the right is the limit of 3 minus x, and that also gives us 1. And the value of the function, well, let's see. 2 is bigger or equal to 2, so it's the second formula that applies when x equals 2, and it also gives us 1. And we say, hey, all three numbers are the same, so it's continuous. The graph looks something like this. We're given this line up to 2, we're given this other line beyond 2, and the two formulas neatly meet in the middle. It's a perfectly nice continuous function. On the other hand, this function is not. If we look at x less than 3, no problem. X squared is continuous. X bigger than 3, no problem. X plus 3 is continuous. But at x equals 3, the limit from the left, we have to use this formula, and we get 9. The limit from the right, we use this formula, and we get 6. The value of the function, we use this formula, and we get 6. 9 and 6 are not the same. It's not continuous. The graph looks like this. It looks like x squared until you get to 3, and then it jumps to x plus 3, and x plus 3 and x squared don't line up. You gotta compare the two formulas at the point to see whether it's continuous at the boundary. Last example was this ratio that we looked at in the last video, except we've got a special definition for what happens when x equals 5. Now, when x is not 5, we can cancel the factors of x minus 5 from the numerator and the denominator, and we just get x plus 2 over x minus 3. The limit as x approaches 5, whether from above or below, is the limit of this expression, which is 7 halves. And that's the same as the value at x equals 5. So it's perfectly continuous at x equals 5. It's still not continuous at x equals 3, because at x equals 3, this expression blows up. It's not defined at x equals 3, but it's continuous everywhere except at x equals 3.